Good evening. How was your day so far? All right. In the morning, how did you take your breakfast? Besides a spoon and fork, what did you use to take breakfast? Hand, good. Left hand or right hand? Most of us also pick up a cell phone and look for email or text. What did you use to operate your cell phone? Hand. So hand and hand and hand. For a moment, think that you lost your hand for some reasons. That will be very hard. Right? But without a hand, you will not be alone. There are folks who have lost their hands at birth, or there are people who have lost due to illness. And there are people who have lost their hands due to war and war crimes, as you see a boy on the left side. Then there are people who lost their hands due to accidents, as you see the young person on the right side. It appears this amputation has no amnesty for age, gender, or profession. So if you look at the stats, in the United States, there are 2 million amputees, and we are adding 50,000 every year. Worldwide, there are 10 million amputees, and we are adding 1 million. So it is estimated by 2050, there will be 50 million amputees all over the world. That's a large number. Ladies and gentlemen, today my talk is about providing a prosthetic hand to those millions of people. Human hand is the best tool that biology has given us. It can do a lot of operations, and its composition and construction is quite complex. It has 26 bones covered by 37 muscles, which give 22 degrees of freedom for the hand. That's a lot, degrees of freedom. Above all, the hand has 17,000 tactile units, that is touching sensors, 17,000 of them on the hand. So, losing a hand is a life-changing event for many of us. And if you notice the hand, another interesting thing is the thumb. Although it is short and fat, it is the most important one of all the fingers. Why? Without a thumb, you know, we can hardly do anything with the other four fingers. But with the thumb, you can do everything. See, that's the important thing. And we take this into account when we design the prosthetic hands. Recently, the wars have become very sophisticated and high-tech. With the result, there is less loss of life and there is more loss of limbs. When our soldiers are coming back home with the lost hands and arms, the United States Department of Army embarked on a massive program to design and build prosthetic limbs. And I had the opportunity to work for the department while I was at Idaho State University. Okay, prosthetic hand. What is the idea behind? The idea is very simple, but the tasks are challenging. Let us say I want to move my hand or fingers. The thought of moving is born in my brain and converted into a signal that travels along my spine, shoulder, and to the forearm, and from the forearm to all the muscles so that the arm operates and the hand is operating along with the fingers. That's how it works. But if I lose my right hand, then that's hard on me too. Then I cannot do a lot of functions with the right arm. But I have a thought of moving my one of the fingers, let's say thumb. See, my thought is there and the signal is there at the forearm. What we need to do is capture that signal and route it to a robotic hand. How do you capture the signal? There are two ways. One is you can insert the sensors under the skin or the nerve, which obviously requires surgery. The other method is you just place the sensors on the forearm, requires no surgery. My research has been focusing on placing the sensors on the forearm. This whole process of extracting the signal and displaying it for us is called electromyography, EMG. Now, you can see here how we placed the several sensors here. There are 9 sensors on the forearm. So you get the signal, you process the signal, and also identify or classify. Classify, I mean, you have to classify the signal, oh, for the movement of my thumb or any other finger. So there are so many signals that come here. In fact, thousands of signals. How do we classify them? This signal is for the thumb, the other signal is for some other fingers. That's a challenging task. And once we classify that, you pass on to a controller built using artificial intelligence and deep learning. So I have a control signal, and that signal you can pass on to the motor, which drives the thumb or any other fingers. So here is a robotic hand we constructed, taking the signal from the forearm. So the idea is capture the signal, process it through the system, and control it so that you have the robotic hand here. Now, this robotic hand that we built costs around $25,000 even at the preliminary stage. But a real commercial hand costs $50,000. So not only in the United States, but the rest of the world, people cannot afford this high cost of prosthetic hands. So when I came to University of Minnesota Duluth, we noticed there is a real revolution in terms of 3D printing, that is three-dimensional printing. And what we did is we got on board to use this amazing technology to do the 3D printing of the prosthetic hands. So with the 3D printing, anything from toys to human organs, you can 3D print them now. So what we did was, with this very basic 3D printer, we constructed the prosthetic hand. I always felt that I should train the future generation of engineers, so I work with my students very closely. Now, there is a video that we produced. So you can see here, the video shows the movement of fingers of a prosthetic hand using 3D printer. And the student is Austin Carter, who worked on the first version of the prosthetic hand. And you'll see the final one that, so that's the 3D printing doing this prosthetic hand. And these are the images of various prosthetic hands that we built at the University of Minnesota. Now, what you see here is on the left-hand side, you have a glove. On the right-hand side is a 3D printed prosthetic hand. This is a project we recently started working, and I like to bring Christopher Bankers onto the stage. And so here is the hand, and the other one is the glove. So I'll be having that glove to operate the one on the right-hand side. So this is this hand and glove system. So we are putting life into this. Okay. Is completely homemade and fresh from the oven. I mean that, because we are putting life into this, that's why just, working. And I'm glad we are doing this first presentation to TED Talk so that you all can see it first. All right. Hopefully it works. If not, we are engineers, we know how to fix them. Right? And here is the expert. So if I move, I'm moving these from my the glove, and you can see the hand responding. What are the types of applications that you can think of? If I am driving, I can do this. Or if I'm mowing the lawn, I can do. Or if I want to lift some heavy objects, I can use this one. Right? I don't want to show the other finger. Chris, thank you for all your work, all right? Well, my vision. My vision for 2025 is to create an affordable 3D printed prosthetic hand that can be used by all amputees. And remember, that is also the surface-based EMG technology, which means I don't need the surgery here. And there are challenging problems, and there are two of them. One is, how do you identify that EMG signal that comes into the forearm? There are millions of operations that a hand can do, and the work is going on with that. The second challenge is touch sensors. As I mentioned, the human hand has 17,000 touch sensors or tactile units. We haven't built a hand which senses that. You know, this is a will not sense. And that's the challenge too. So my vision is to work on these challenges and come up with a prosthetic hand that is affordable. Now, the other interesting thing that we wanted to do is put this whole thing on open source. Which means this technology is accessible freely, and the prosthetic hand is available at an affordable price to all those millions of people all over the world, and make sure that this disability disappears from the face of the earth. Not only Earth, but Moon and Mars. These are the two targets for us for the next exploration. So, give a hand, give hope and happiness.